worship, I don't know what will happen. Does everybody have your bulletin? Order services down the back. On the inside will be our service music, which has the Gloria, and then the song we sing when we bring offerings for it, and the thank yous. Those are all found in there. So with that, I'm going to get... Oh, everybody needs a green Wonder Love and Praise hymnal, so make sure you have one of those in your hand or nearby. We've got enough. They're just kind of spread around. So if you don't have one, you need one. We'll get one to you. All right, then I'm going to get quiet now. I'm inviting everyone else to do the same. We'll get ready to worship God together. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be your kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Let us pray together. Almighty God,
to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Gloria is inside your bulletin. And saw his children and his children's children 4 generations. And Job died old and full of days. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please read with me Psalm 34 by half verse. I will bless the Lord at all times.
His praise shall ever be in my mouth.
I will glory in the Lord.
Let the humble hear and rejoice.
Proclaim with me the greatness of the Lord.
Let us exalt his name together.
I sought the Lord, and he answered me.
And delivered me out of all my terror.
Look upon him and be radiant.
And let not your face be ashamed.
I called in my affliction, and the Lord heard me.
And saved me from all my troubles.
The angel of the Lord encompasses those who fear him.
And he will deliver them.
Taste and see that the Lord is good.
Happy are they who trust in him.
Many are the troubles of the righteous.
But the Lord will deliver him out of them all.
He will keep safe all his bones.
Not one of them shall be broken.
Evil shall slay the wicked.
And those who make the righteous will be punished.
The Lord ransoms the life of his servant.
And none will be punished who trust in him.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. The former priests were many in number because they were prevented by death from continuing in office. But he holds his priesthood permanently because he continues forever. Consequently, he is able for all time to save those who approach God through him, since he always lives to make intercession for them. For it was fitting that we should have such a high priest, holy, blameless, undefiled, separated from sinners, and exalted above the heavens. Unlike the other high priests, he has no need to offer sacrifices day after day, first for his own sins, and then for those of the people. This he did once and for all when he offered himself. For the law appoints as high priests those who are subject to weakness, but the word of the oath, which came later than the law, appoints a son who has been made perfect forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel hymn in the green hymnal, number 773.
Bartimaeus, son of Timaeus, a blind beggar, was sitting by the roadside. And he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth. He began to shout and say, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." Many sternly ordered him to be quiet, but he cried out even more loudly, "Son of David, have mercy on me." Jesus stood still and said, "Call him here." And they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take heart, get up, and he's calling." So throwing off his cloak, he sprang up and came to Jesus. Then Jesus said to him, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man said to him, "My teacher, let me see again." Jesus said to him, "Go, your faith has made you well." Immediately he regained his sight and followed him on the way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I think it's important for all of us to know the stories in the Bible. And, you know, we can say, we know, if you say Noah's Ark, you kind of know what happened, right? Job, different, all the different stories. And this is one of those stories that kind of has a title. We call this Blind Bartimaeus. Oh, you're preaching on blind Bartimaeus today. In the story, he cries out to Jesus to be healed, to have his sight restored. And Jesus says, "Okay, there you go." But it goes deeper, because once he got his sight, what did he do? He followed Jesus. I think I have to read into that anyway, that it wasn't necessarily just his physical eyesight that was fixed, but his inner seeing, that he could see that the one who healed him, the one who restored his sight, was someone he, Bartimaeus, was going to follow. The eyes of faith. Jesus says, "Your faith has made you well." Now, it's kind of a scandal, and it makes many of us pouty, but the truth is, Jesus did not physically heal everybody. He healed people here and there, maybe groups. But there were many, many people living in the time of Jesus, you know, just think about it in the human sense, that were not healed by Jesus. Sometimes the only reason they get healed, they get a healing miracle from Jesus, is because they go out of their way to get Jesus' attention. Bartimaeus is crying out, "Jesus, have mercy on me. Come on, help me, help me. Woo! I'm over here, I can't see." The woman with the hemorrhage reaches out and gets, that's another story. Reaches out, touches his cloak, gets his attention. He felt power go out, he goes, "Okay, you touch me." They were actively seeking the attention of Jesus and asking to be healed. Because Jesus, in our stories and scripture, doesn't heal everybody physically, we can accept that maybe in this life we have ailments and weaknesses and shortcomings. But even as our bodies may be challenged with these things, our inner seeing is where we can look. That's where we want our blindness to be taken away, our sight to be restored, to be able to see the world around us and what's really real in it, to see God at work in the world around us, and that there's real reality in that. To see maybe where God is seeing to be absent. That's our inner seeing. And that's where where Jesus really heals us. Just like with Job. Derek pointed out, it was interesting this morning. Job says, I could hear you with my ears, but now I can see you, Job is saying to God. His eyes have been opened to the reality of God, not just hearing the stories or reading scriptures or knowing what people say or do, but his inner sight. He says, I can see now. God wants us to have our eyes open. God wants us to see the reality in the world around us, but we have to see with our spiritual eyes, our eyes of faith. And what is that? That is seeing the world and the people and the things and the creation through God's eyes, through our spiritual eyes. What would God see if God looked on this or that or me? Job says, oh yeah, now my eyes are open and I'm really blown it. Oh, yes. When we see through the eyes of faith, we can look at ourselves with our eyes open and to see who we really are on the inside. Who does God see when God looks at us? And the reality is most of us, at least from time to time, are not going to like what we see when we use our inner eyes to see ourselves. And often maybe don't even like what we see when we use our inner eyes to see stuff around us. But we have to see with the eyes of God, who sees us as beautiful, perfect, lovable children, that God wants to help us and protect us and nurture us and hold us accountable and challenge us and test us and sometimes tell us no, because in the big picture, God wants us to see who God is. And in seeing who God is, we can see we're not God. Now, the problem is that when our eyes are open, when our spiritual eyes are open to see the world through God's eyes, there are things that we see in this world that we just cannot unsee. Okay? Once your eyes are open, you start seeing, you can't unsee it. Now, we can turn a blind eye. I don't, I have to flip the channel on TV and a Humane Society commercial comes up because I can't stand to look at it. But over time I had to realize, you know, you do see it, Melinda. You see that suffering. Stop pretending you don't. Stop turning a blind eye. You got it. And then once we see, we have to do something. Many of us, and I know I do every day, pass by homeless, mentally ill, panhandlers, some we think might be worthy, some we think might not be worthy. The problem is, it's sort of like, I've done this, I bet many of you have too. You get to the corner, you go, just God, don't make eye contact. Don't make eye contact with that poor person over there. And if I just don't make eye contact, I can pray it and can. But the fact is, God says, open your eyes, and once you see that, what are you going to do with what you just saw? Because you can't unsee it. How many of you have ever been in a place, in a room or somewhere, where it's absolutely pitch black, you couldn't see your hand from your face? Has anybody ever experienced that? Okay. I did. I was deep in the heart of a Target store a long time ago. The power went out. And it was literally, couldn't see. It was absolutely paralyzing. I'm pushing my cart along and all of a sudden it's black. And I didn't know where the people were. That lasted probably about 2 minutes. It seemed like 25 hours. It's like you can't go, you can't go back, you can't move. It's paralyzing. And I think until God turns lights on, God restores our sight, we can find ourselves being paralyzed in the darkness. It only takes one little match, though, to dispel that darkness. When we pray, God, restore my sight, know what you're asking for. Because when your eyes are open to see the spiritual way, the theological way, the incarnate way, to see as God sees, you're going to see stuff you can't unsee. And then you have a choice to make. You can turn a blind eye, or you can be like Bartimaeus, who once his sight was returned, jump up and follow Jesus. That's the choice Do you want your sight restored? I hope so, but get ready. God has a lot of stuff to show us. Continuing on page 358, let us stand and affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in God,
the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Loving God, raise up for the Diocese of Montana a shepherd who will lead with compassion, with courage, and with comprehension of the needs of all your people, that we may be led by a bishop who is committed to ministering from the mountains to the plains, from cities to rural areas, always remembering the poor, the marginalized, and those with no voice. This we ask, Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The prayers of the people are Form 1, found on page 383 in the Book of Common Prayer. With all our heart and with all our mind, let us pray to the Lord's name. Lord, have mercy. For the peace from above, for the loving kindness of God, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all peoples, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, for Michael, our presiding bishop, Franklin and Carol, our bishops, Melinda, our rector, Gary, Jerry, and Carolyn, our clergy, and for all clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Donald, our president, Steve, our governor, Bill, our mayor, and for the leaders of the nations and for all in authority, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the city of Billings, for every city and community, and for those who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For seasonable weather and for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the good earth which God has given us and for the wisdom and will to conserve it, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel on land, on water, or in the air, or through outer space, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the aged and infirm, for the widowed and orphans, and for the sick and the suffering, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those on our prayer list, Jean,
Gabby, Jolene, Ben, Rachel, Kathy, Michaela, Carolyn, Rainey, Amber, Jerry, Jim, Ashley, Sophia, Jesse, Kay, Jim, Carrie, Danielle, Gary, Diane, Jeff, Rosemary, Jenna, Diane, Charles, Mary Jane, Bruce, Neil, Karen, Larry. For those who served in harm's way, Stephen, Alex, RJ, Meredith, Vandy, Kendall, Chris, Chad, Michael, Levi. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the poor and the oppressed, for the unemployed and the destitute, for prisoners and captives, and for all who remember and care for them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Lorraine Williams, and for the victims and their families of the Tree of Life Synagogue, and all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, and for all the departed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For deliverance from all danger, violence, oppression, and degradation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the absolution and remission of our sins and offenses, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may end our lives in faith and hope, without suffering and without reproach, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Defend us, deliver us, and in thy compassion protect us, O Lord, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
In the communion of St. Luke and of all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord, our God.
In the Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for the Church of the Province of West Indies. In the diocese, we pray for St. James Dillon, Susie Rector. We pray for our preschool, the wardens, vestry, and parishioners, Jerry Waddingham, Marnie Walter and Megan Lowe, Tom and Kim Weber, Dick and Sharon Wood.
Almighty God, to whom our needs are known before we ask, help us to ask only what accords with your will, and those good things which we dare not, or in our blindness cannot ask, grant us for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Continuing on page 360, let us confess our sins against God in our name. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Ascribe to the Lord the honor due God's name. Bring offerings and come into God's courts. And our offertory hymn is number 460.
Thank you.
Give us this day our daily
Our sending hymn is number 411.